हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम प्रियंका गुप्ता फ्रॉम सेठ विद्या मंदिर इंग्लिश हाई स्कूल एंड जूनियर कॉलेज। आई विल बी टीचिंग यू हिस्ट्री टुडे। टुडेज सब्जेक्ट इज हिस्ट्री, क्लास 10th, टॉपिक इज हिस्टोरियोग्राफी डेवलपमेंट इन द वेस्ट। चैप्टर 1, हिस्टोरियोग्राफी डेवलपमेंट इन द वेस्ट। So student, now in this lesson we will first discuss about some important points. In this lesson, the first point that I will show you in your screen, we will see the historical research. Second point, this is a continuous process where writing, studies, research is carried out to understand the chronology of the past events and their interconnections. Come to the third point, the empirical method is used, which means that laboratory method of experiments and observations is used in physical and natural sciences to verify the knowledge which is available. Come to the fourth point, in empirical method, we can formulate laws that remain true without any time and space barriers. Fifth point, but in the historical research, the empirical method may not be possible to use as we were not present in the time and space in past and those events cannot be recreated. And the sixth point, to begin, we need an expert who knows the language and script of a history document to read and understand its meaning. And in the next page, there will be last point in this chapter that I will explain you, to check the authenticity of the document, the lettering style, author styles of writing, manufacturing date, style of writing and type of paper, stamps of authority will be scrutinized by a historian with the help of historical references. Now here I explain some points in your screen with the help of some pictures. The first point, historical research, writing and studies are carried out with an objective of understanding the chronology of the past events and their interconnections. This is a continuous process. In the physical and natural science, the empirical method, laboratory method of experiments and observation is used to verify the available knowledge. This method allows formulating laws that remain true respective of the time and space. Those laws can be tested and proved repeatedly. In historical research, it may not be possible to use the method of laboratory, experiments and observations. This is so because we were not present in the historical time and space and the historical events cannot be recreated. Also in history, it is not possible to formulate laws that remain true irrespective of the time and space. To begin, we need an expert who knows the language and script of a historical document in order to read it and understand its meaning. Also, the experts can examine the authenticity of the document by using criteria such as lettering style. Author's style of writing, manufacturing, डेट एंड टाइप ऑफ पेपर स्टैम्प्स ऑफ अथॉरिटी एटसेट्रा. सच अ डॉक्यूमेंट इज फर्दर स्क्रूटिनाइज्ड बाय अ हिस्टोरियन विद द हेल्प ऑफ रेलेवेंट हिस्टोरिकल रेफरेंस. मेथड्स ऑफ वेरियस डिसिप्लिन्स आर यूजफुल इन हिस्टोरिकल रिसर्च. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आर्कोलॉजी, आर्काइवल साइंस, मैनुस्क्रिप्टोलॉजी, एपिग्राफी एंड स्टडी ऑफ इंस्क्रिप्शंस. एनालिसिस ऑफ लेटरिंग स्टाइल, लिंग्विस्टिक, न्यूमिस्टमैटिक, स्टडी ऑफ कॉइन्स, जीनोलॉजी, स्टडी ऑफ लिनेज एटसेट्रा. Mention some flowchart on your screen. Historical research method, writing of historical narrative. Here are some charts that should be connected with the writing of historical narrative. First one is examine relevant references of the available historical information. Collecting historical information, highlighting the processes that lead to historical transition, carrying out comparative analysis, understanding the references regarding time and space of the given historical events and the also various conceptual framework used in historical research method. And the next one, formulating relevant questions in view of the historical reference, formulating hypothesis. And the last one is critically examining of various sources of history. We have learnt about the historical research method, critically examining the historical sources and writing the historical narrative. A scholar who writes such a narrative is a historian, is known as historiography. The historian cannot include every past event in his narrative. The inclusion and interpretation of historical events by the historian often depends on the conceptual framework adopted by him. His style of writing is determined by the conceptual framework. The tradition of writing historical narrative, that is historiography, was not prevalent in the ancient societies of the world. However, that does not mean that they were not aware of the historical time or were not eager to know about it. In fact, ancient people also felt the need of passing on the stories of the life and valor of the ancestor to the next generation. And the ancient communities all over the world used various means like cave paintings, storytelling, singing songs and ballads, etc. for this purpose. Now, these traditional means are looked upon as the source of history in the modern historiography. Now, in the historiography development in the West, in this chapter, we are talking about the characteristic of modern historiography. In this first point, its method is based on scientific principles. It begins with the formation of relevant questions. Now, the second point, these questions are anthropocentric. Anthropocentric means interpreting the world in terms of human values and experiences. 3. Answer to these questions are supported by reliable evidence. 4. History presents a graph of mankind's journey with the help of past human deeds. It is said the modern historiography with above characteristics has its roots in the ancient Greek historical writings. History is originally a Greek term. In the modern historiography, in the Greek term, Greek historian of the 5th century BCE, Herodotus, the Greek historian of the 5th century BCE, used it first for his book entitled The Histories. Here I mention some summary of Herodotus. Herodotus, a Greek historian of the 5th century BCE, as we know that, is known as the father of history. But long before Herodotus, ancient civilization like Sumer civilization of Mesopotamia recorded history in form of inscription on rocks dating back to 4500 BCE. Writing and historical narrative is called historiography till the 1800 century. Writing history only meant arranging historical events in chronological order. With changing times, the method of writing history became scientific and also included the social and economic factors of historical times. This gave rise to modern historiography. Now, student, this is the description of Herodotus, and so student, in this chapter, what will we see? In first of all, we see the meaning of history, and then tradition of history, after then tradition of historiography, after then tradition of the ancient people, and then we will see some modern historiography, and then we will see some characteristic. Basically, there will be four characteristics of modern historiography in this chapter, and last we will mention about the Herodotus summary. So student, I hope you will be understand, and goodbye, have a nice day. With regard, Priyanka Miss.